Hi.
And welcome to
welcome to the
secret
sex life.
Welcome to the
secret
sex life.
Kenyan men. No, it's not that one. It's welcome to the
boys
club podcast.
What makes a man kill? What keeps a woman still? What makes a baby grow up and not consume the pills? To keep the babies, baby, baby, from the wombs of babies. He's in a mysteries, a life to foot a jibuwezi. Pata pata ka polisi, lojo mbili, sponsor fiti, nyama mbili, bafu chafu, kimwi sunu daddy, nagono gino maybe. Yeah. What makes a man kill?
Radio, the secret sex lives of Kenyan men is happening
tomorrow.
Tomorrow. So you can get the Zoom link.
Pin location.
Chalice, do the thing.
So yeah, me at Shemikan Force Field.
At Steve _ Agushas Pali Instagram. But famously known as Captain Spali.
At Octave Saint Octavia.
In the last episode, that's what you almost said.
Captain Sparrow, nikakumbuka Johnny Depp ameshinda country moja, can lose country nyingine.
So ameshinda country, okay. The news, yo, guys.
Like, see, alikuwa na court case.
Yeah.
In the US, he won. Mm-hmm. In the UK, he lost.
Really?
Yeah.
I did not
true,
know.
True, by the way.
Yeah,
Amber is from the UK.
How informed should men be?
Him, he's from the UK.
No, informed. Well, you put up a mob, like 15M, man.
Yeah.
At least you know something today.
Yo! We will always use this against you.
Yeah. Anyway, guys, so today, our guy, Mr. Right here, has all the cards, Mona. Mm-hmm. You know, the guy, the silent guy.
The
hopefully not. Let's see.
Yeah, Mr. Right, and I'm on the right. So, guys, today we are going to talk about economy. Mm-hmm. This is something that affects all of us generally. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can see, Banaleo, to me, back up a businessman. Rich young niggas. So, to start us off, guys, we want to talk about the famous Expressway in Nairobi.
The famous.
It is very famous.
Very famous, bro. Yeah.
It's one of the
oh, famous ni kujulikana.
Yeah.
Popular ni.
Okay, don't go there.
Cheki.
No, don't go there.
Nauliza. Nauliza tu.
Moja ni kupendwa, kujulikana, ingine ni kujulikana tu.
No. Haya, ni famous.
It's a very famous highway in Nairobi.
Yeah.
Guys, that is what we want to start this podcast with today. At least each one of us is going to tell us what you know about Expressway and what you think about Expressway.
Yeah.
And if you have ever used Expressway, you'll also tell us how did you feel. So, Captain Sparrow,
yeah, yeah. You know, I like this podcast because we talk about things we've never used, but in a manner that looks like we know shit.
SDG
Social Development Goals. Development Goals. They were hoping that one, it will reduce the one problem in the city, which is basically traffic. Traffic jam. They introduced a system that is in the UK and I think in the US, where we have toll stations. So for toll, UK, US, unalipanga sijui $2, unapita kwa toll station bill. Now, in Kenya, they've introduced that system. But is it working? Like, I see people prefer the jam to the expressway for some reason.
Basically, it greatly affects the economy. For example, watu wenye wanaishi Nairobi, unapata mtu anafaa afike job mapema, but sasa kuna jam, sindio? For example, kama maitumia Mombasa famous for that. So they were actually trying to offer a solution to that by building the expressway. But then it is a solution, yes, but again it is not, because you are spending a lot to use the expressway.
Yeah.
You have to pay to use the expressway. Alafu bado utafika tao uambiwe ulipe parking tena. Unaona? Hiyo ni like double tax. Unaona?
Ni like how much kutumia your toll ni how much?
I was actually looking at it and niliona they charge different for big cars, the trailers and such. Wana charge between 600 to 1800
for big cars or for
Big cars.
Okay, big cars being like pickups,
no lorries, trailers. Alafu for the saloon cars they charge between is it 200 or between 120 to 360,
which is depending on the length of the route you're going to be using.
It depends on how yes, the length of the route you use. Yeah.
So kama unashukia for example Nairobi West, because I hear the toll stations are also renamed.
Yeah.
The first one was called Nairobi West, but now it's been changed due to public demand from Lolongo. Yeah. So if you're going the whole route from Lolongo all the way to
Westlands,
then you're going to pay the 360. But there are exits sapo katikati.
How long is it? Is it 27 kilometers?
It is 27 kilometers.
Yeah.
Basically, when you use the expressway, you're going to take 10 to 15 minutes. Ukitoka tu Mlolongo hivi uingie, unaona Mombasa Road uingie tu Mlolongo expressway. Speed ni 80, unafaa kuwa above 80. So unaweza enda hivyo mpaka Westlands na 10 to 15 minutes.
So in a speed limit, you gonna minimum speed.
You gonna minimum speed.
You know, expressway. Yeah.
But ukipitia chini jam, itakuchukua close to between 2 hours and 2 hours 30 minutes to 3 hours to get to Westlands.
Yeah.
You need like to say you need rush hour time.
You need rush hour time.
I'm a normal time.
Normal time na itakuchukua close to 1 hour kufika. Kutoka tu Mlolongo mpaka Westlands. Normal time ina maisha kuna jam unasonga. That will take you around 1 hour, 30 minutes. Okay. But kama kuna jam, itakuchukua between 2 hours, 30 minutes to 3 hours. No one unaonanga, my cousin who watches the podcast, leaves his house at most of the times, 5 o'clock in the morning. Unajua anaenda wapi? Tao tu. And in a place yenye, ukidrive usiku, like I think we were with you last time.
Yeah,
we take 15 minutes from town without jam, CBD, to Kahawa. 15 minutes.
Yeah.
But ukitokanga 5, utatake close to 45 minutes. Na hiyo utakuwa ume beat the jam. Ukitoka later, unachukua 2 hours. Place yenye ukienda usiku unachukua 15 minutes.
So with the expressway, it saves time.
It saves time.
Yeah.
So essentially we are paying for time.
We are paying for time.
You save time but then you spend for
so guess the time that you save. Like tulitengeneza kitu ilikuwa expensive, so in a way of paying for it, as we actively paying for it as we use it.
Yeah, for example, there's this guy was saying that when he's using the expressway, he will possibly spend like 18,000 in a month for the expressway. Ujue hajalipa parking, hajafuel hiyo gari, hajapiga service ya hiyo gari.
Okay, so yeye anatumia the whole route, like
yeah. Probably anatumia the whole route. So akitumia kila siku, and is it that unalipa ukiingia and then tena ukitoka ulipe, or is it
unalipa per way?
I don't know
if this is right. Maybe I'll just look at it. But I hear there's an account you create and then a code you're given. So you load money into the account. So every time you're passing through the expressway, saa zingine, your tag ina readiwa tu na hizo cameras, alafu pesa inakatwa. Na wewe unaenda. You don't need to stand there at GMP. You just load money into the account, so it just cut as you go.
Oh, wow. So wait, if I go, see, it has two endings.
Yes.
If I come from home, I go through it in the morning, I pay.
Yes, you pay.
That does. No? Yes. And then when I come back in the evening, if I don't want to go through the jam again, I want to pass through it, I pay again.
You pay again.
the hell? See, I paid in the morning. Why am I paying again?
My issue is not even about you paying in the morning, Octave.
Okay.
My issue is you're a taxpayer. Mm. You've paid taxes, and these taxes are supposed to help develop the country as it is. Why on earth am I being charged to pay for a structure that I've paid tax for? I don't remember being told that I'll pay for the expressway, not the expressway, the new roads in Nairobi. I don't remember being told I'll pay.
For example, when they built the Thika Super Highway,
yeah,
you didn't have to pay for
it. I don't remember
paying. And actually, paying, yeah? Thika Super Highway, as much as bado iko na jam, but at least imesaidia.
Yeah, a lot. Yeah. I don't remember paying at all for the SGR. Do you remember paying at all for this year?
Econa
fee, but that is in transport. That is in the fare you're using to on the train.
Yeah.
But you're not paying at this new kando na hii fare. Kuna hii pesa unafaa lipa juu tulijenga SGR.
Zinongoliza cash unalipia reli.
Now guys, as much as we are talking about the expressway, we know that in Kenya right now, most young people have cars. Right?
Yeah. Quite a number, actually.
Yes. But quite a number of young people.
Can we all appreciate that, man? Tunaenda kuona toll booth maisha zetu, man. Tunajua hiyo nini sasa? We know what a toll booth is.
It hasn't changed my life in any way. So.
Yeah. So we have.
Mimi nilikuwa nimeshiba kuiona kwa movie. Expressway ndo tulipe toll tusikie ina feel aje.
Fanya hivyo, si unataka experience.
Imenisaidia aje experience.
Hiyo ndo barabara, hiyo ndo barabara.
Unataka experience?
Wewe ukitaka kupanda ndege unafanyanga nini?
Nishapanda ndege.
Okay.
Ulifanya nini?
Si nilienda kwa airport nikapanda ndege.
Sawa.
Sasa wewe panda gari hiyo ndio
okay. Kwa hiyo experience nilikuwa naenda majuu kutembea. Sikuwa nimeenda kitu serious. Niko na ufala bana.
Wacha siku moja kitu serious itakupeleka kwa hiyo expressway
tu. On that day I will. But see at me talk to.
Bado itakuwa guys. Bado itakuwa part of the experience.
It's a new thing in Kenya. We must enjoy this new thing.
Yeah, so
how much happens when young men want to use
expressway? Wacha tukoje vitu serious.
You should know that in the Kenyan roads unaweza shikwa juu kwa overspeed. But kwa expressway utashikwa.
Unashikwa juu
kwenda. So niende kwa expressway.
Unashikwa juu kwenda chini ya speed.
So niende kwa expressway tu ndio ni speed.
Unaenda kutoka ndio. Kuna swali. Kwa hivyo nilipe toll ndio nisilipane huko kwingine ama?
Wait.
You get
wait,
out.
Check it. Wait. Now, I think I need us to talk about something else.
Uh-huh.
Young guys with cars.
Yeah.
What is it with the young people with cars like? Every young person wants to own a car before they reach a certain age.
Was it?
Eh.
I think tu niyo iko na kajina na uko na kagari man. Uko na kagari. Maze.
Sasa unajua shida ni uko na hiyo kagari. But sasa unaumia chini ya maji, unaona? Because owning a car actually is not easy.
It's like having a baby.
You need to feed the baby. You need to make sure that the baby is clean. You need to make sure.
Afadhali mtoi. Tunasema tu leo.
Eh. Afadhali mtoi. I feel scared.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So some of these young people, they own cars, but wanaumia. Not all of them actually. No, not all of them. Some of them actually wanakwanga wamejipanga. But sasa it is really overwhelming how many young people out there really want to own cars. Yeah. I don't know what you guys think about that.
I think it's
Octave Saint Octavio.
yeah, the holy man. So mi naona ni psyche alive. Unajua, like people they want to chop life, huh? A chopping. So I have a car, nini, hizo vitu. Una get? Yeah. But kwa watu wa, kwa wenye wamejipanga si mbaya, but unajua kuna watu wase wengine wenye hawajajipanga. Ni ile site tu nataka niishi maisha mzuri, kapesa kameingia hivi kadogo, probably corruption ilipita mahali fulani ama scam say ama unajua hizo mavipi. And then tunaingia hii biashara, niko na gari, niko na hizi shit zote, unaona? Some people like even get into like very bad loans because of that, just getting a car and things like that, no, no. But it's not bad if mtu amejipanga. The problem comes with when sa ujajipanga alafu vitu zingine za maisha zianze kukufuata. For example, ukisha buy gari, mtu anataka gari akuwe na mtoto sasa. Eh. Hey.
Okay. See, isn't pressure zinasumbua watu. Eh. Hey, yo. Nikipata gari naanza kutafuta mtoto. Eh. Hey. Yo.
Unaona venye our parents. Yes. Ilikuwa unamaliza shule, unaingia job, ukiingia job, you buy the house, after you buy the house, you buy the car. Ndio. Eh, yeah. And then you'll choose whether you'll have children before you buy the house or after you buy the car. Unaona? Hivyo.
Goja, so mimi na niko na shida na logic.
Si okay, hebu sema wewe kitu unasema.
Chalo
kidogo.
Give us your big thoughts. Give us your big thoughts.
Bana kuna big thoughts. Kuna big things. Anyway. Nini?
Sawa.
Like logic kwa hapa. Nauliza hapa kwa sababu tunapigana na hii logic, si ndio?
Yeah.
Like watu walikuwa patana, si ndio? Mm. Wanapata gari kwanza ndio wanapata watoto.
Like
oh,
wewe mtu ni different.
Oh,
kuna
oh,
wale yeah, wenye alikuwa yeah, kokampo ashapata dem wana washakuwa na mtoi anamaliza mm-hmm, anaingia job, anabai nyumba, anabai gari. Mm-hmm. Unaona?
Yeah, yeah.
Kuna yule msee ako tu kampo anacheza cheza kivi yake na enjoy maisha yake. Anaingia
that
job, anabai oh, nyumba, anabai gari, then anatafuta bibi.
Okay.
Yeah. Unaona? Like our folks they went through that kind of.
Yeah, like, you know, like everyone plans yeah, for it differently.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now us, because first economy imeshatu
piga ile
tray, unaona? Eh, imeshatu charge. So tunaanza kupiga hesabu kutoka hapo. Our parents expect us to kind of be like them because of course everything on this earth is made by other human beings. But sasa situations zetu na circumstances zetu ni different, unaona? So now there's someone who wants to chase that life like that, but now hana uwezo wa kuimaintain. Sasa shida inatokea hapo. Unaona?
Alafu Steve, can you give yes, us your big thoughts about young people with big cars?
First of all, we get too much pressure from seeing young guys with cars. But mostly when you look at it, some of these young guys with cars are being given cars by their parents. Umesikia? Msee ana show up na Outback KDH. Amekaa nayo for like 3 months uko like hii gari ni ya umse. But hata ukimwangalia, bado mko shule na yeye. Umesikia? Maintenance ya Outback is not that cheap. So you realize that it's either there is something else he's doing, but at the age that he is, there is a possibility he's not signing contracts and getting millions. So hii pesa natoa wapi? So most of us are under the pressure because one, watoto wameanza kupewa magari na wazazi wao. I have a friend with a very nice KSL. But sasa, the problem is
Shots fired.
Yeah. The problem is in the society we've grown up expecting young guys to have vehicles that they have been given by their parents. Now, me who's seated there would be like, come on, sana za kuwa na gari. Without thinking further about it, I'm like, even to buy a vehicle. The problem is ule mse ana service wa gari, anapewa mafuta, anapewa hizo pesa za kutumia na kila kitu. Exactly. Wewe unaanza from scratch, uji service ya gari, ujifanyie hizo vitu zote. Umesikia? Most people fail at it because one, they did it for clout.
True.
But other people manage. Why? I always tell myself, when you aim higher, you get there if you're consistent enough. Umesikia?
Mm-hmm.
So nikikaa chini mimi niseme nataka kubai gari, na niko na ile will ya nataka kubuy gari because I want to buy it, not because my friend is buying it.
Mm-hmm.
Your life will actually match up. pesa zako zaanza kuja, pesa service itapatikana, pesa mafuta itapatikana. So inakusaidia kujichallenge in life, kujiambia I need to get there and you will. And like ule mse mwenye alihandiwa gari na akapewa kila kitu, yes, kutamuachia hivi 1 month, mwambie buji manijie by the way, ataweka hiyo gari kwenye.
Actually it is true, yeah, that some of us young men actually go out of their way to do anything they can, bora wamepata ka job yenye inaweza ingiza do, watafanya hiyo job. And watu saa zingine they don't get that ati watu wengine actually work for their money. Unaona?
Hata zile zimekuwa job inaweza kuwa kuuza body parts.
I guess kuuza kwa gari swali tunastahili kwa tukijiuliza ni why. It's just why are you doing it? Why are you buying
that car? There are two reasons why people buy cars. Let me just speak from what I know. The two reasons why people buy cars
according to Captain Sparrow.
Fake one.
One
fake Captain Sparrow
with no amber.
Black Captain Sparrow.
The two reasons why people buy cars is one,
no amber.
With no amber.
Just a Kim. But not Kardashian.
Wow. The two reasons why people buy cars is the two reasons why people buy cars is one, because of clout, and two, because of convenience. The major reason why people buy cars is one, because of clout. People rarely buy cars out of convenience. Like atupate msame buy gari juu ya ninaenda places mingi na nimeona kutumia matatu inaenda kuni take time, umesikia? So let me buy a car because it will help me maneuver, buy my things, carry my things, umesikia? Angalia baso yuko na ma Volkswagen Polo ama Golf Sport GTI, hizi fupi fupi. Cloud! Tutokeleze Volkswagen Run, tutokeleze hizi ingine netuangwa suji aje. Ni cloud. Young people with vehicles attend motor shows for cloud.
Subaru boys.
CSI meetings, yeah. Wewe anda angalia mse mwenye amebuy gari out of convenience, akona Volkswagen Passat, uone kama ana show hivi hapa. Anapanga business suit hivi, anaenda na business suit hivi. Anda kijana. Huyu alibuy gari out of convenience, anajua nini anafanyia. It really breaks down. Patana na kakijana akakuwa na gari hapo. Kuna kapita hivi na Nissan Tida. Una bahati.
Mimi najua professor akona.
So hapo ni cloud na
akona Honda
cloud
Fit.
Cloud na convenience.
Professor mzima kuna Honda Fit, alafu wewe kijana mdogo unataka
Mazda Axela Atenza 6 ya red KDG.
Sawa, hizo gari ni mingi wale.
Wewe jamaa kwa
personal bar.
Personal bro.
Wewe kama mwanzo kupigana by the way.
As we wind up.
At this point man tunataka fikia ile point tunasema kuna ka break. Tunaona
ngoma zetu.
Eh, so we're with us, we're still talking about economy. Tumefika kwa magari side, do not leave us so far. Sawa. Eh, tunaendelea. Sawa. So yeah guys, the Boys Club podcast going on a break.
Yeah.
See you soon, man.
See you soon, man.
Cheers.
Makes a man kill, what keeps a woman still, what makes a baby grow up and not consume the pills, to keep the babies, baby from the wombs of babies, he's in a mystery, a life that future jeep wears.
The sense is not even making sense for him.
My coffee.
Welcome back to the show, man. Tumerudi.
Yeah,
and this guy was telling us something new or something else.
Remember, we were talking about economy, right?
Yeah.
Now this is something that is affecting all of us. Now I'd like to just hear your big thoughts about the general economy. What do you think about the Kenyan economy and the world at large? And how is it affecting you? And
Kurugenzi. So like economy man. Tuanze hapa man. Ugali ilifika lini 150
juzi?
Wow. I mean as in unapiga hesabu ya like venye vitu zimerise over the past few years and especially this year too, like everything unashtuka man. Hadi sosi ya 20 mesonge ikakuwa 25 man. We can't cope man, economy is yo, what is happening?
Na salary iongezeki
man, imagine
kushuka.
Unaona na mimi niko like man, but look at our future. Our future is very bleak. Come on, it's very dim. Yani
everything inongezeka as we grow older, meaning by the time sisi ndo watu wa job, sisi ndo tuna own houses, sisi ndo tuna own Subaru. Anyway.
Sisi ndo tuna own
German
things.
Why you pointing fingers?
Yeah, eh, umsa alisema kuna German Shepherd hapo, labda mkuze mtuangali. Anyway. Yeah, so like sisi ndo tuna grow up na economy, sisi ndo tunaenda kuwa wazazi, unaona? Mini youth are coming. Unaona?
Yo, yeah.
Unaona? So what about? And now the problem is economy, nah, like you know how you this is how you spend. Mm. So, how much do you get on this other side also? Is it fair? Is it really fair? Unaona? Because on one side people are like man kuna watu ajui hata kubageni nini unaona yana nanga anapata price ni 10k sawa shika credit card saa kwisha hiyo story ilienda unaona eh na wewe kuna ule mwenye uko
alafu unapata unaona hao si waku swipe hao ndio wako kwa hizo maofisi za huko juu they have like they have control over the economy but there's nothing they are doing about it unaona hao wanajua tu wataenda hapo wafanye hiyo kitu unaona alafu wacha nikupige advice kabla uendelee hapo kwa ugali kuna kisiagi hapo unaweza
kisiagi
azizi
unaweza pitia hapo
kisiagi wewe kisiagi tuonge onge bana economy.
I understand him, especially in your story ya unga.
Yeah,
we asked some nigga to bring us maize, and then he went, Amanda happy.
Amanda happy. Iko, yeah. Iko.
And then now we are hungry because alienda na maize.
Story
yeah. Anyway,
he went to Molo.
He went to Molo. Now we have no maize, man. Ugangu jari jara. Anyway, have you ever seen campaigns and how they look like? Let's just go back to 2012 or was it 2017? Ushaiona ile picha ya campaign yenye Jubilee walikuwa na when they're waving flags. I think you pia tafanya ile kitu.
Yeah,
yani we elected these guys with all these red flags.
You're a joke.
We elected these guys with all these red flags.
Yeah,
as you is it politics or politics?
Both actually.
Juu like seriously okay see hivyo but we are where we are right now because of the government that we have in power. So it's all sanga song wakasema tumekopa madeni kutoka China
au tukupe
tumekopa madeni kutoka China na bado zingine hatujalipa. Umesikia? Generation yenye ina come, I don't think itakuwa able kuclear your debt unless they do the Crip-Toe-Currency.
Unajua hapo kwa ukiongelea generation, ukiona actually umeongelea Crip-Toe-Currency na generation at the same time.
Yeah.
You find that wase Crip-Toe-Currency kwa wenye wajui ni wale watu wa
Zimbabwe
wenye wanakata
kidole na wanapewa good ranger.
Toes. For example, we have toes. One of us mwenye kuna
two toes and a car. A German machine.
So, in Zimbabwe actually,
ameuza hadi za buka.
In exchange for cars. Unaona? In exchange for cars. And if you've looked at those videos and pictures, they are actually young people. Yes. They are very young people.
Okay, mimi niko na kitu ya kusema hapa juu ya story ya economy. Okay, the government has done whatever it's done. They are people, they are human beings just like us. They have their problems and things like that.
Yeah.
Okay. This thing is usually said kama ni kitu mbaya, but mimi nataka niiseme kama kitu mzuri. We are very skeptical on if we will pay his loans, which I think is not a good thing to do. Okay, anyway, we were having a discussion before that we started about like China and loans and all these things.
Yeah.
You know? I think economy ni standard interest yamse and the interests of the people in power controlling said economy.
Mm-hmm.
If they have their own interests, they are going to work on them as much as they are working on interests of to same country and whatever. Mm-hmm. Kuna mse nani TikTok and DJ La Pose and asema corruption will never end. And he gives a very nice example. In Western countries, there still is corruption, but it's covered up because now wako na infrastructure, nini systems, all these things.
Yeah.
Africa, hatuna hizi, hatuko,
haiwezi kuwa covered up. Build infrastructure.
Exactly, and these guys are stealing way more than they, okay.
They are stealing with stealing. Impunity.
Yeah. With impunity, you know. Because they have to maintain a certain lifestyle that has been put to them through societal pressure.
Yeah.
Mi naona, tuwache kusema, hatuwezi lipa hii loan.
No, you don't.
Yeah.
Tunaweza, but under the right conditions.
Yeah.
I think we should be complaining about the conditions of paying these loans.
Mm-hmm.
It's not bad that we took them, but now, how are we going to pay them?
And but you know, the funny thing is, these loans have never affected us before. It's just that we've come to a point we've realized, hey bro, to make up our pesa, mob. The problem is not that tunafikiria, we are going to pay these loans. In fact, I think when these loans are paid, we never really know atujuangi zikilipwa na atujuangi zikichukuliwa. But ziulipwa.
But
shida yetu sasa unaona saa hii, tumekuja ku center sana on the loans perspective because imefika mali tumeanza kuumia economically. So tunatafuta mtu wa kublame.
Alafu unajua, something else is that the problem is not about the loans. Mm-hmm. The problem is how the loans are being used.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What for?
And what for?
Mm-hmm.
For example, if of course we took the loan for the expressway,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And we are very sure hiyo pesa yote haikutumika kwa expressway.
No, haikutumika kwa expressway.
Ndio.
Yeah.
Now, where is the rest of the money?
In someone's pocket.
In someone's pocket, right?
Kuna mtu yako anajua anasoma na pesa yetu ya corruption.
Okay.
Kenya sihami. Hey, mi Kenya
tuende wapi?
Niende wapi?
Ai hapana. Atuhami lakini tunapenda ku travel.
Unapenda mapita pale Twitter.
Yeah, KOT gang. Eh, tuende.
Eh, so if ingekuwa hii pesa yote inatumika for something productive,
mm-hmm.
at least something would be coming out of the whatever we have done with the money to help repay the loan.
Mm-hmm. No, ata hapo kwa productive. Okay, what exactly is this thing? Because now, for example, I kind of have a problem with the expressway because, okay, now it exists. Mm-hmm. You know, yes. How many people is it helping?
Exactly.
A little bit. I guess.
How many people is it helping?
The well off.
Is it a project that, first of all, unajua, ukichukua loan, unapiganga hesabu, unachukulia hii loan nini? Uwezi chukua loan for personal enjoyment.
Yeah.
Unachukua loan.
Eh,
unaona? So if it's a loan of that scale, unaona? Eh. What if we had more roads that have tolls around Kenya instead of this one has this extremely large nani? Unaona?
But again, you know, to pay. About the expressway, when you wanna put these things in place, most of them don't even use that expressway. Wanapaa huko kwa hewa.
Wanapaa kwa hewa.
So,
speaking of party.
So you wonder, wanataka nani alipie hiyo kitu.
Like, okay.
Hao wenyewe hawawezi. Na they are the same guys who have put this thing in place.
Okay, okay. Before, do you know if government officials pay the toll also? We know?
No,
we don't. I don't know. It's just me now.
Maybe the ones who don't have copters.
Like if government officials use the expressway, are they paying for it?
I think they don't really pay for it because it is the same thing as general parking. Mm. They don't pay for parking in towns and cities. Government cars don't pay for parking.
But mini connect. Wait. Last time I was just looking at it, and then nilikuwa naona 20 V8 zimepita ra. Unajua ku fuel V8 ni 10k.
Mm.
Full tank. Okay. So kama 20 zimepita hiyo ni how much? 200k.
Yeah.
Ku transport mse mmoja. Yeah. My problem with this economy, it has been caused by COVID. And then Museveni once said, "Let's stop depending on outside countries so that when their things go up, our things go up."
Okay.
Unasikia? Because now that there is no fuel, the cost of living has increased because everything that we get is usually transported by fuel.
But allow me
wait. Problem yangu inakuanga tu moja. Vitu zikipanda, possibility yazo kurudi chini. Inakuanga
tu.
The problem is I'm getting 10k when COVID started. COVID has ended, I'm still at 10k. COVID has continued and economic crisis ya mafuta imekuja, bado niko 10k, lakini vitu zenye na buy sahi zime triple ama zime double in price.
Yeah.
So which means, nilikuwa natumia 4k on food, sahi natumia 6k on food, alafu 4k nilikuwa nalipa rent. So rent imebaki constant, 6k nalipa food. So pesa yangu imeisha, ile 2k nilikuwa na save sahi.
Now I just want to say something. Okay, finish and then
malizia.
No, me as in nilikuwa nataka ku bring in the fact nakumbuka hiki tu ni it's like extreme. Unaona ngai snake flani yenye inajiumanga te.
Yeah.
Like it's a halo, whatever that thing is. Unaona that thing with a stress snake yenye inajiuma te. Sawa. In this sense. Sawa. Yangalie we have a lot of loans that we can't pay as a country.
We can't pay yet.
Okay, we can't pay yet as a country. Sawa, which leads what? Fanya vitu zianze kuongezeka bei pole pole. Meaning, hawa tu wako huku chini sasa wenye wanaanza kushindwa kulipia hizi vitu, tunashindwa ku cope. Meaning they also have to take loans now.
Yes.
To deal with that. Meaning,
you know the sad part
it's,
is
it's a whole
the sad part
conundrum.
Hizi vitu zinapanda bei and the excess money is not actually being used to pay back the loans.
Mm-hmm. It's not.
Yes, that is the sad part.
Yeah.
Now, I just wanted to say, with the economy, I have realized that it greatly affects people living in towns and cities compared to people living in Ushagos. Yes, for example, unajua mwenye ako Ushago, akona kashamba yake hapo na nini, akona jembe yake hapo, ataenda kwa duka, anunue mbegu, unaona, apande. Ya akona food.
Yes, mafuta tu ndo inapanda bei.
Ya akona food.
Akona food lakini bado ako kwa shida.
Yes, ako kwa shida but not as much as compared to mwenye anaishi kwa tao. Unaona. Juu yeye lazima anunue unga, lazima anunue mboga, anunue mafuta, anunue nyanya, anunue nini. Unaona?
Yeah.
Mimi mama yangu pale nyumbani akona shamba, si ndio? Anapanda nyanya yake hapo. Anapanda mboga yake hapo, si ndio? Season ya mahindi atapanda mahindi hapo, season ya maragwe atapanda maragwe hapo, si ndio? Hiyo ndio atakula, for example, atanunua tu mafuta peke yake, si ndio? As much as mafuta imepanda, anunua mafuta peke yake.
Na nyama
bado akona
hata nyama si lazima anunue.
Hata nyama si lazima anunue, akona ng'ombe hapo.
Na amepanda nyanya yake
hapo. Eh, unaona? Atachukua mahindi kidogo aende apatie mtu wa duka apatie mafuta ya kupika. Aende apike, si ndio?
Mama yake amepanda nyanya yake kwa shamba.
Let us all go back to butter.
So, tulikuwa tunamalizia.
Butter.
The economy, me and just say this as my take. Last year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The economy is fucked up. And I think we are going to recover. It's going to take a while, but we are going to recover. Pole pole too. But over-dependence on foreign affairs is what is making us suffer also. So, I think if we minimize on that, we might be good. Peace
yes.
out, guys.
Chalo, your check, please.
Okay, for me, basically, guys, man, economy kumbaya ni ukweli, sindo iko, as he has said. But, tukumbuke, man, sisi ndo tunaenda kushikilia economy uko mbele. So, we be involved in it, we be part of it, we should know what's actually happening. Vitu tu zisi happen, na wetu umestukia by the kitu ili happen. Na ni kitu ina kuaffect. Unaona? Wendo unaenda kupata hiyo kazi, wendo unaenda kukua na hiyo gari, wendo unaenda kufanya hizo vitu zote. Wendo unakula, wendo unapita hii transport, unaona? Everything that is here that is affecting us economically, it is for us also. So, remember yourself and be involved, man.
Watu wafanya research wa kuwe informed.
Yeah, mazim kuwe nifanya, yeah, research.
Yo, so... positivity, yeah, positive vibes. We might not be able to pay our debts in this lifetime
yet.
We might not be able. Statistics, so but we should not give up on living. I mean, like, yeah, these things exist, problems are always there. Yes, it's true, our salaries are not even increasing and the cost of living is getting up and up and up. But wase wenye, we are in an election year, the people we are going to be electing into those offices and things like that, we should make them know to think the way we are thinking ourselves, unaona? Because them, loan inachukuliwa, anakula hiyo loan kabla itumike, loan inatumika tukilipia toll, hiyo toll bado pesa inakulwa hapo kabla ilipwe huko mbele, unaona? So we are facing trouble two time, una get? Kuna generation ya leadership inatoka, hii generation ya leadership inaingia, itabidi mmekuwa accountable for sisi, hatuwaachi. Hawa ni wazee, hatuwezi waambia shit. Lakini ni wenye mnaingia hiyo base,
kidogo hatuwaachi. Hawana red flag.
Yo guys, very important, learn to budget. Very important, learn to budget. By the economy sahi natupeleka vibaya, but as the little that you have, just budget for it. Ikufikishe mahali usipige sherehe sana. Unajua unafaa kule. So just learn to budget and please beware of your economy. Pigeni research, mjue chenye inaendelea. So that is my take. We are having a very productive discussion today.
Yeah.
We just had a very productive discussion, and I hope you guys have enjoyed our discussion for today.
I want to do the thing.
So guys, this was the
yo. Tomorrow, Friday the 10th of June,
yes.
The Secret Sex Lives of Kenyan Men is premiering in theaters around Moi University main campus, and then on Sunday 12th of June it will premiere on stages in Eldoret Town, especially at Sirikwa Hotel. So those of you who like plays and such things, the play is written by myself and acted by them also. Yeah, you see they look like they're kind of like in costume. So if you're anywhere around,
hii look yetu ya kawaida.
Hey, look yangu unaita costume. Hey. How do you call my
so if you're anywhere around Moi University main campus, you can come through to lecture theater 2 and see the performance, and if you're anywhere around Eldoret, you can come to Sirikwa Hotel on Sunday.
But we also have Zoom links. Yeah. So if you want to watch us online, you can just
comment down below.
Comment down there, leave your number there, we'll send you the link.
Yeah. There's enough for everybody.
Yeah.
I am Agushez Other Sparrow, famously on Instagram as team_Agushez.
Yeah, man, say Shemekan first feel. Big up Zoom dance crew, yo guys. Yeah.
Octave. Say it out.
Shadi Adenya at Instagram. Actually, all social media platforms. We'll see you next week.
Keep your boys club.
Keep it better blind.
As we look for attention, mabisha zetu ni masnake. Kazi yao kuimpraise, watashinda wamelie. Nyuma yako rumor mongers. Madem zetu ni was, looks zao ni mafilter. Unaweza download, only a few be real. One truth stands out, madem wetu applications. Hata tujaribu aje, no difference involved. Tukilala tukiamka, Kingston they'll call us. When the lights go out, sisi wote masimu. Tuko Facebook, tuko Twitter, kwa WhatsApp, tuko status. We looking, we ain't touching, as we slaves to the memes. We are screwed, we are fucked, that's what they'll tell us. Tumerise juu ya yote, we are heroes, we are free.